Hey there, YouTubers, it's Don from True Cable coming back at you again. And today we're going to talk about going fast with your communications cable. We get a lot of questions about Category 7 Ethernet, Category 8 Ethernet, fiber optic, and Cat6A, and where it fits in, and what's the best cable to go with when you're talking about wanting to go fast with your setup. What we're going to get into is where Cat7 is used at, where Cat8 is used at, their speeds. And then we're going to talk something about fiber optic as well, because that is definitely the future. If you're considering copper twisted pair Ethernet for your network, really you should be cutting it off at Cat6A. And the reasons will become clear in a moment. So Category 7 Ethernet cable. Now, this is a so-called Cat7 patch cord, and it was purchased from an online retailer. And there's a couple of things that you need to know about so-called Cat7 patch cords. Category 7, first of all, is a ISO standard. It's not an ANSI TIA standard. So the United States, we don't have Cat7. This is a European standard. And essentially, Cat6A and Cat7 are equivalent in performance. The other problem is that this patch cord and many other so-called Cat7 patch cords you see have these RJ45 or 8PHC connectors attached to it. That's actually not how you connectorize patch cords for Cat7. It's actually using GG45, not RJ45. It's incorrectly constructed from the get-go. Although they stamped Cat7 on the cord, you can't call it Cat7. In the end, it doesn't operate any faster than Cat6A. It's designed for 10 gigabit networking out to the maximum of 328 feet, all things being equal. Now, Cat8 really is different. It's a different animal. Cat8 is typically seen in its shielded form, although it doesn't have to be shielded per the standard, where Cat7 actually does. In ISO standard, Cat7 is a shielded cable. In the Category 8 realm, you have 10 gigabit networking up to 328 feet, but Cat8 can also do short hauls and maintain 40 gigabit networking. So up to 98 feet, assuming everything is good, you can achieve 40 gigabit between two pieces of equipment. This is most useful for data centers, as well as short hauls between two telecommunications rooms, like for two pieces of equipment, like two switches that can do 40 gigabit over copper, which is not all that common. So Cat8 does have a place for temporary short haul high speed runs, 98 feet. But after 98 feet, you're right back to Cat6A performance. So now we're talking about Cat6A again. It keeps coming up. I wonder why, because really Cat8 is the end of the line for copper twisted pair Ethernet. You're not going to be seeing any Cat9 or Cat10, not unless physics has somehow changed and I'm unaware of it. So you can only get so many bits and bytes over copper twisted pair. And Cat8 is really the end of the road. Now, when you want to go faster than Cat8, or you need to go longer than 98 feet and you need to get 100 gigabit, for example, that's when we start talking about fiber optic. Now, this is multimode fiber optic, and it's a Erica Violet. This is OM4, although it could be Aqua as well. With Category 8 Ethernet cable, you've got yourself 40 gigabit to 98 feet, all things being equal. With OM4 fiber optic, multimode fiber, you can get 40 gigabit up to 500 feet, and it can achieve 10 gigabit to 1300 feet. So if you need to go a long distance with your 10 gigabit networking, or longer than Cat8 can go with 40 gigabit, then that's when you would opt for multimode fiber. However, multimode fiber is slowly being phased out. It is a much older fiber optic standard. It's been around for quite some time. It's gone through multiple revisions, OM1, 2, 3, 4, and now 5. Multimode fiber is still being sold and used because it's relatively common. It's great for really high speed, not terribly long runs, like maybe campus backbone, stuff like that, where you're not going past 1300 feet per 10 gigabit. Where you're gonna get your maximum speed is going to be with single mode fiber. And this is OS2 single mode fiber. It's yellow, and that's how all OS2 single mode fiber should appear, is yellow. And this particular type of fiber optic cable can go kilometers. You can transmit 10 gigabit many thousands of feet with single mode fiber. You can transmit 100 gigabit at very long distance as well. So if you're looking to go a long, long distance or very high speed at relatively shorter distances, then a single mode fiber is what you want. But if you're looking to maybe economize, save a little bit of money, you can go with the OM4 multimode fiber, and it's still going to give you way more than any potential copper Ethernet cable can do. There is one thing, though, that fiber optic can't do that copper Ethernet will always be able to do, and that is power over Ethernet. So if your needs are power over Ethernet, then you are restricted to copper twisted pair Ethernet cable to transmit data and the power over the same cable. Now you're restricted to copper. So hopefully that helps clear up some of the questions around what category gets used where, what fiber optic is used for, how it benefits over the copper. Please subscribe to our channel. Give us a thumbs up or a thumbs down as you see fit. Leave some comments below. Let us know what your experiences have been. You know, is there something that you prefer, one over the other? What things have you had a bad experience with or good experience with? And with that, I'm going to say you have a great day and happy networking.
I hope you enjoyed that fiber video. Interested in learning more? Please check out either our Cable Academy up here, and if you really want to see more, check them out here.